Episode 23, The Newtonese Civilization. During the era when the angels were busy building the Frogid Kingdom, the oracles had regenerated themselves. The mass disaster had swiped them away, to the southern pole of the earth, where they had lost their lives in the process. Their souls followed their bodies, and gathered them at one place. They modified their bodies, to be suitable for dwelling under the water, and reinstated themselves within their newly modified and invincible bodies. They then look for a suitable place to build their headquarters. They spot a cave and decide to proceed with it. They settle down for a while before meeting for a discussion. Rakistos, glad to be finally back. Agniras, indeed. It had been a long and painful journey. But now it's a relief. Avini, I still wonder where the angels would have been. Agniras, as usual. Hiding in some crevices like mice. They all share a great laughter. Praenira, life angels oracle, but wherever they shall be, I am sure they would be up to something. Something big. We need to know. Rakistos, what else would they be doing? Apart from building a colony of slaves, who would oblige their lives serving the angels? Antheta, death angels oracle, then what are we doing here? Let's go and hunt for them. Rakistos, at ease. Antheta, at ease. Praenira, but we can't just sit here, waiting for them to build their tribe, and then get slayed by them. Rakistos, do you still think they are capable of that? We wiped off a whole population from the earth, where they had taken refuge. It's they who are to fear us. Not the other way round. Besides, we need to attack them, before they find us out. Agniras, what are we supposed to do? Rakistos, build an army. An undefeatable army. Venomous enough to drive away every breath from those lazy, vulnerable angels and their tribe. Venom is the only element on which they would not have control. Agniras, do they still have any control over other elements though? Rakistos, yes. That's again a known truth. Praenira, so, what are we to do next? Rakistos, let's explore around and see what we have. They move out and survey their surroundings. They come across various creepy marine creatures. Praenira, what do we specifically need to look for? Rakistos, look for the critters that can be transformed into a bipedal human-like structure. They come across various such creatures adapted to marine life, such as bichirs, crustaceans, hellbenders, and newts. Praenira, let's go with the bichirs. They look terrifying the way they are now. Imagine how would they look when they morph into bipedal human-like creatures? Rakistos, bichirs. You mean the blind scavengers? They crawl on the ground and hunt for leftovers and dead bodies to devour. We need to build an army of warriors and not gypsies. Antheta, then what about the hellbenders? Rakistos, they look dreaded and are huge too. But they are not venomous. Rather, they are shy little timid creatures who like hiding beneath the mud. I need something active and venomous. I think I found it. Look at these shiny colorful beings. Rakistos lifts a newt from the ground and admires it. Rakistos, look at it. So cute by appearance, but killer from within. Their toxin is a killer in its own might. Humans feared their toxins. Some of our human tribes used their toxins to apply on the spears and arrowheads to make a deadly weapon. These critters are perfect for our new civilization. The Newtonese. They gather a huge cluster of newts and surround them. The oracles shoot beams at the cluster together and transform the newts into bipedal human-like creatures. The Newtonese look at each other and their newly developed body structure. Rakistos, don't worry. You shall get used to it. You are our new tribe. The Newtonese. The Newtonese stare at the oracles. One of them gather courage to speak. The Newtonese, who are you? Rakistos, we are those who have risen you from those creepy slimy critters. We are your creators. Your gods. The Newtonese bow at the oracles and start following their orders. They build clusters of dwellings to stay closer to each other in the neighborhood so as to ensure safety and security in the neighborhood. They build clusters of farms in appropriate zones for optimally harvesting the resources. Society-wise, they only had three primary classes. Those were the civilians, the politicians, and the militia. The civilian class composed of general public, who were involved in civic activities like farming, building, civil services, teaching, infirmary, and all sort of local services, meant for serving the society. The politicians were from the class serving the oracles, with political planning and affairs. The militia class consisted of the defense personnel, and warriors. The oracles had ensured that their militia was strong enough to counter the mystical powers of the angels. The Nutanese kingdom was named as Nutania, or the land of Nutanese. The Nutanese, although were venomous, their behavior or the society wasn't so. There was no distinction among the classes in terms of facilities, though hierarchy-wise, politician class had a higher precedence in terms of respect, as they were directly working for the oracles. The Nutanese were polite among themselves, and never raised any social conflict. They respected their oracles, and never ever dared a rebellion. They lived a very happy and content life. Little did they know, that they were nothing but being trained, to be puppets at the hands of the oracles. They trusted the oracles at such extent, that for them, oracles were none other than the mirrors of truth. The words of oracles were final verdict for them, and nobody ever questioned them. The trio at Aztatnagrals were regularly monitoring the activities of Nutania and the Frogid Kingdom. They realized that the Nutanese were hard-working, loyal, innocent, and were only the scapegoats of the oracles, who had raised them to execute their wicked plan. They feel pity on them, and make up their mind to free them from the evil clutches of the oracles.